Ready? Fight!
Here we go. 3 5-minute rounds. Judges will score the contest in its entirety. Oh, a big coming together. And Burns goes down. It was a right hand that was thrown from the Russian.
Immediately starts to transition and plays a dangerous game with the leg locks. But Khaibulaev does the right thing. And look at that wrestling from Khaibulaev. He's able to suck in his hips, keep it on control. But you gotta wonder, is that where he wants to be with somebody as skilled as Herbert Burns is on the ground? Elevating the hips there, locks in, possibly going for an omoplata. Khaibulaev is able to fight it off, but he gives up his leg. Now Herbert Burns has got that leg in a pretty dangerous position. If he can lace that left leg over,
Khaibulaev is not scared
at all.
They are big guys for featherweights, well-muscled. They look really strong, don't they?
Khaibulaev is controlling this position. He's not scared of the guard of Herbert Burns. You can see Herbert Burns trying to open up his hips, swivel out to the side, possibly attempting a sweep. Has a high guard on one side, able to control the shoulder there. Khaibulaev starts to drop a little bit of the elbow there just to soften up Herbert Burns a little bit with the top ground pressure. I asked Khaibulaev if he was, you know, nervous about exchanging grappling exchanges with Herbert Burns, and he looks at me, points to his partner, the guy in his corner right now,
Yusuf,
and says, that guy, Murat Gafurov, is every day on the mat with me. So you think I'm scared of this guy when I got that guy on top of me? No chance.
There's the two high-level guys to be training with every day, Murat Gafurov and Yusuf Sadulayev.
Look at the spider guard of Herbert Burns. He's able to control that hand. That's the spider guard. Oh, he's got a possible triangle, but lets it go. The spider guard with no gi is actually really difficult to pull off, to control that wrist and then place your foot on your opponent's bicep. But Herbert Burns has such a long reach. His arms are so long for his body that he's able to use it in the grappling exchanges so well.
Yeah, he's got great natural tools for this sport, hasn't he? Halfway mark of the first round.
See, you can always tell a high-level grappler because they won't close their guard. They won't trap their opponent in their guard. They'll open up their guard and then consistently looking for angles. See, his hips are constantly swiveling from left to right, looking for possible openings. Controlling the arm, the head with one side, so Khaibulaev can't posture up and drop big bombs. Really good active guard from Herbert Burns.
Defense.
Constantly swiveling out from left to right.
Stand up.
And Olivier Kos wants him standing up. And, what's your thought on that, Mitch?
It sounds like the stadium does too.
Swinging back fist from Herbert. They exchange. Certainly the excitement level rises when they're on the feet.
They are throwing some serious heat.
They really are.
They
both looking to land big bombs. Just right hand happy, the two of them there in the initial exchange each time. Let's see if it happens again. A jab settles things down slightly.
Big looping right hand from Herbert Burns. Khaibulaev jumps him with that hook. I like how he's landing that hook. A little bit of a slow jab there from Herbert Burns. Not really putting any pop onto his punches.
Approaching the final minute of this opening round. There isn't much of a pop in Herbert's punches.
They're more like just range finders, trying to find that range. Maybe possibly going to slide under some of these strikes and end up in a double leg, maybe a shot coming.
Khaibulaev's right hand seems pretty heavy when he throws it.
Yeah, he throws some serious leather over that right side.
Herbert gets his hands up nice and quickly. And it's Herbert that's doing the pursuing, just a foot length at a time.
He's moving forward, but you see how he's circling away from the power side of Herbert Burns. Herbert Burns is right-handed, so that right hand is going to be his biggest weapon. Oh, nice right hand! And Khaibulaev lands it, turns Herbert Burns around a little.
That's it, kid.
You got 10 seconds left in the first.
It's been a nice mixed up round, hasn't it? On the floor, standing up.
Just a little bit more snap in the strikes of Khaibulaev. He's just able to do a little bit more pop, a little bit more power coming from his shots. There's a body kick landed by Herbert as Khaibulaev jumps all over him and starts swarming on him. But there's that spider guard that I was talking about. Look at that, how he's able to control the wrist with his left hand and then pops his foot onto the bicep of Khaibulaev. Very impressive guard action from Herbert Burns. Rich, how do you have that fight so far?
I'll tell you what, a lot of things happened in that round, but I want to focus on the ground control here. Khaibulaev landed the takedown early in the round, and they're both doing a good job on the ground controlling. It is very difficult, like you said, Mitch, to pull off spider guard with no gi. I don't think I've actually ever seen that done before. Herbert's constantly attacking submissions, but nothing that's really had Khaibulaev in trouble. However, Khaibulaev has been able to stay in his guard, land some significant elbows and stuff like that. So at this point in time, I have him actually edging out the ground control just a little bit, which puts him ahead on the scorecards when you factor in things like takedowns.
So overall, Khaibulaev just ahead on Rich's scorecard. Second round coming up. 3 5-minute rounds for this one in the featherweight division. A stiff jab from Khaibulaev.
Now Herbert's putting a little bit more emphasis into his punches.
He's got to be careful of that right hand, Herbert, hasn't he? Because it comes in with power. It's a thudding punch.
There's that jab. See, now he's got a little more snap to his striking exchanges.
Oh, right hand from Khaibulaev was very tasty indeed. And another solid left jab that threw Herbert's head back, followed it up with a right hand, spinning kick to the hip.
He's landing a lot of these strikes. His hands are just slipping right through the guard of Herbert and just landing ever so gently, not gently at all, but very effectively splitting the guard of Herbert Burns. He's just a step faster.
Another very powerful left jab, follows it up with the right hand. Herbert's guard is looking a little porous.
Well, look, when Herbert Burns throws out that slower jab, Khaibulaev's able to come over the top.
There it is, just as you said it, Mitch, exactly that happened.
And land that big right hand. Herbert Burns has got to be very careful throwing that jab out there.
I'm loving this jab from Khaibulaev. The spinning back fist is causing Herbert trouble. It's a great fight for this crowd at Stadium Negara to watch here. No Malaysians involved, but they're just enthralled as we are at the competitive nature.
I'm surprised Khaibulaev followed Herbert back down to the ground. He was so effective in his stand-up. Yeah. He was really landing some significant strikes and doing some damage. Herbert looked noticeably damaged there, just shaken. Khaibulaev again lands a big right hand.
Nice left there from Khaibulaev. Now he'd probably be wise to back off and let Herbert get up. And that's what Olivier is telling Herbert he must do if there's going to be action in this one.
Exactly,
this is where Khaibulaev has had his success so far. And that right hand looked very pedestrian from Herbert.
Look at the snap of that jab, just splits right through the guard of Herbert.
Listen to the crowd getting into this one. Kuala Lumpur, oh, that's a super kick to the head.
That front kick just split the guard and he follows it up with a big right hand.
Wow, he really tasted that one and then took a big left. And Herbert's in a little bit of trouble here. Khaibulaev is putting on quite a show for us in Kuala Lumpur. And
Herbert tries to get the fall into guard and it worked. Khaibulaev actually followed him back down to the ground.
He actually kind of, he faked the drop to the deck, didn't
he? Very effective there from Herbert Burns to get this fight. He was getting lit up there for a minute, doing some damage to Herbert Burns. Herbert fakes the fall, and Khaibulaev falls for it and jumps right into the guard of Herbert Burns.
Here we are, though, surprised that Khaibulaev is engaging on the ground, but Rich is telling us that he's controlling the ground. So, maybe it's wise to get down there.
He's stopping a lot of the attacks, and he's not really been putting any danger on the ground.
Khaibulaev is just opening up Herbert Burns' defense in this second round with a barrage and a great variety of attacks. The spinning back kick, that solid left jab he's got, a right hand as well, and those brutal kicks to the head.
It looks like all the hype that has been following Khaibulaev is legit. He is definitely putting on a show here tonight in KL.
Again, I think Herbert just ducked down there hoping that he'll be joined by his opponent, but I don't think he wants to get involved, does he? It's the second time we've seen Herbert sort of fake the knockdown in the hope that Khaibulaev will go in for the finish. A little bit too long in the tooth at 10-0, though, to fall for that. Gets the leg caught and takes the right hand again. Herbert goes down, wanting him to be joined on the deck there. But he's not having it, is he?
You can see his corner trying to tell him to back off, let Herbert up. Fight. And that's what he does. But Herbert Burns is not out of this. He's consistently moving forward. He's throwing that jab and a spinning kick of his own.
What an entertaining contest this is. I don't think I've seen that so often from a fighter, not in one round. Taking a punch that wasn't really strong enough to knock you down, but then going down so that you'll invite your opponent to come down too.
See, there's that jab. Khaibulaev lands, splits the guard of Burns and lands a nice front kick. There's that spinning attack. Herbert Burns had his guard up nice and high, deflected that one. But the story of this fight has got to be the stripes of Khaibulaev, Rich.
Yeah, actually, you know what? I want to show you the whole graphic here because this is a good reminder that we don't judge on a round-by-round basis, but it's cumulative from the beginning. Most of the ground control that was scored there was from the first round. This second round has been all about the striking and striking superiority. Khaibulaev has found a good home for his right hand. He landed a nice front kick. He's starting to do some damage. He's been a bit aggressive, making Herbert Burns change his fight style, dropping guard and all that kind of stuff. So at this point in time, Khaibulaev has extended his lead on the scorecards and he's ahead significantly.
When you look at Rich's graphic, right, it's important to note that it's not just the amount of color on one side as compared to the other, but the color towards the top of the chart carries more weight than the color towards the bottom. So keep that in mind when you see Rich's graphic and you hear him take you through what he's seen so far.
There's got to be some urgency coming from Burns here. He's got to start putting together some shots, not throwing these one shot, because every time he throws that jab, Khaibulaev is able to come over the top with a right hand of his own. Now you can see a little bit of urgency coming from Burns, but he's walking into some punches here.
Got to be urgent now, Mitch. Final round. And hit takedown.
Woo! Beautiful. Stop the shot. Interlaced the leg and had a takedown of his own. Beautiful. Now he's inside control, the world champion, Herbert Burns. Look at him trying to pin down the arm. Herbert was having none of that. Looked for Khaibulaev to try to soften up Herbert with some punches.
Just over 4 minutes left. They're on the mat, although he may not be in the most advantageous position, but what can he do, Herbert Burns, to turn this around?
He's got to try to escape. So you can see he's trying to turn his hips out to the right side there, and that's the directions he's got to go. But you see how Khaibulaev has his right hand so close to the hip of Herbert Burns, so it's preventing Herbert Burns from moving away and escaping out the side there. So he's not able to create any distance. And Khaibulaev is just so strong to keep him in that position like that. And he's just able to drop punches and elbows with that right side there. And that's exact. See, he's got the knee on the hip there of Herbert, and he's got the arm there trapping Herbert Burns in that position.
Well, those knees to the head are dangerously close to the back of a head, which would be illegal blows. You can bet Olivier Costa is watching that carefully.
He's probably going to try to pin down the left arm of Herbert Burns into a crucifix or maybe shove it between his legs so he can start to punch a little bit more. That elbow there, knee, those really aren't doing a lot of damage, but it's hurt. I mean, it's cumulative over the time. And on Rich's scorecard, you can see that striking superiority is coming into play even here on the ground.
He's only 26 years old, Khaibulaev.
Oh, nice escape. But Khaibulaev was able to transition into mount. This could be it, but look at Herbert Burns escaping out the back.
Good job, and he's got the heel. Now what can he do with it? It slips away. Woo. 2 minutes 30 left. glimpse of an opportunity there for the Brazilian.
With a grappler, the capability of Herbert Burns, you never know. Even when he is mounted, he was able to slide out the back and look for a leg lock. So he's consistently in this fight. And now he's working his way back into guard. He's kind of got the butterfly guard there, but his Khaibulaev's pressing him up against the cage, so he's not able to create any space. Herbert Burns is trying to elevate the hips there. But Khaibulaev is just so strong. He's just got so much top pressure.
Fence.
Working to slide the knees through, and he passes the guard.
Running out of time, Herbert Burns. Less than 2 minutes now.
Now he's back in the side control position. Look at him pinning that arm there and just soften him up. See, he keeps trying to step over the right arm to kind of just open up, because Herbert Burns is able to defend the strikes with that right hand. So Khaibulaev's actually trying to kind of pin the right arm down so he's able to open up and strike a little bit more. But Herbert Burns has got a good defense from this position.
It's got to be more than just defense for Herbert, though, now, Mitch. He's running out of time to have an impact on this contest.
But you see how fast he throws up these submission attempts? So he's still in this fight, even with only about 60 seconds left to go in the third. But if it does go to the judges' scorecards, according to our vice president, Rich Franklin, the nod is going to go to Khaibulaev. Look at that control. He's just able to, the way he's pinning the hips down with the knees and the arms, he's just able to control the position from so many different angles.
Worth noting that the featherweight champion, Marat Gafarov, is of course a teammate of Khaibulaev. They're not going to fight each other. Khaibulaev's already said that.
Look at that, he pins the arm down. He takes away the base from Herbert Burns and just drags him back down.
And sends some leather into his face with that left hand repeatedly as well. Burns taking more punishment than he'd agreed to when he signed for this fight, I'm quite sure.
10 seconds.
Just dominating ground control from the undefeated killer, Movlid Khaibulaev.
Herbert Burns, the Brazilian, has surely run out of time to have an impact on this fight. We have seen a very impressive performance from 26-year-old Movlid Khaibulaev. Came to one championship with a 10-0 record, and there's every indication that that is going to improve.
Look at that, the way he slid past and just put knee on belly into mount, but then just controlled it. This is where Herbert Burns was able to escape out the back, given one last attempt at a submission, interlocks the legs there, but Khaibulaev does all the right stuff in stopping the submission attempts from the world champion, Herbert Burns. Very impressive victory. Rich, break him down for him.
I'll tell you what, Khaibulaev is a grinder. He's a featherweight, and I bet he feels like a heavyweight when he's on top of you. This is a perfect example of our scoring. He was a bit more aggressive. He won the takedown category, which led to ground control. As time went on, he was controlling more and more. The striking in that second round was amazing, and it started to accumulate damage. I have him ahead on the scorecards for sure.
Dominic Lau is the man with the official decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds of battle, we turn now to the judges' scorecards. All three judges have called this fight in favor of your winner by way of unanimous decision, Movlid Khaibulaev.